Now we have to find the gravitational potential energy. We know that gravitational force F between the two mass body M1 and M2 is the attractive force given by the Newton's law, that is F equal to gm1 m2 by r square. And this gravitational force is conservative in nature. It means that work done is path independent. In other words, we can say that work done depends on the initial and the final position. Suppose there is a mass body m1, and from this m1 there is another mass body m2 at a distance r. So gravitational force will be equal to gm1 m2 by r square, and this is always an attraction force, so force on the m2 will attract or act towards the m1. To move the m2 opposite to the m1, we have to apply some external force F external opposite to the gravitational attraction force. And due to this external force, suppose this mass body moves from position R1 to R2. So work done from 1 to 2 to carry the mass M2 from position R1 and to R2, it will be equal to integral R1 to R2 F external into dr, F dot dr. This is a dot product, so we can write it as R1 to R2 F dr, and angle between external force and the displacement is 0 degree, so it is cos 0 degree. Cos 0 is 1, so we can write it as integral R1 to R2. Gravitational force and the external force are equal in magnitude, so we can write it as g m1 m2 by r square into dr. G m1 m2 is constant, so it is taken out of the integral, and remaining is 1 by r1 to r2, these are the limit, and dr by r square. From integration we know that integral of 1 by r square is minus 1 by r, so it will be equal to g m1 m2 minus 1 by r, lower limit r1 and upper limit r2. So it is minus g m1 m2, upper limit first, this is 1 by r2 minus 1 by r1. And this work done w1 to 2, it will be equal to the final potential energy minus initial potential energy. Now we consider a reference point, that is that initially r1 is infinity, so potential energy at this point, that is at infinity, is taken 0, and this is the maximum value. So we can say that u2 will be equal to minus g m1 m2 1 by r2 minus 1 by infinity, and 1 by infinity is 0. So, and because only one subscript is existing in this expression, so we can left with this subscript, and we will have u is equal to minus g m1 m2 by r. This is the potential energy between the two masses m1 m2 at a distance r. In case of earth body system, suppose m1 is the earth, then we can write the potential energy of the body is u is equal to minus g me, this is the mass of earth, into mass of body divided by the distance of the body from the center of the earth. So this will be the potential energy. And potential energy also satisfy the principle of superposition. So for an isolated system of the particles, the total potential energy will be equal to the sum of the energies for all possible parts of the constituent particles. Using the concept of the gravitational potential energy, we will derive the relation of the escape speed. Escape speed is the speed of the particle with which, if it is projected, then it come out of the gravitational pull of the earth and never returns to the earth. Suppose the body is projected with a speed VE, that is the escape speed from the earth surface, then we can write that gravitational potential energy plus kinetic energy at the surface of Earth will be equal to the gravitational potential energy plus kinetic energy at the infinity using the principle of conservation of energy. This implies that gravitational potential energy at the surface will be minus G ME M by RE. Here ME is the mass of Earth, RE is the radius of Earth, and small m is the mass of the body. Plus kinetic energy will be half given to the body, it is the mass of the body, into escape velocity VE square. This will be equal to the gravitational potential energy plus kinetic energy at infinity. At infinity, we have taken that gravitational potential energy is 0, so it is 0. And for minimum escape speed, we have to taken the kinetic energy as 0. So it will be the total energy at infinity. So using this relation, we have half m v e square. This is equal to g m e m by r e. M and m get cancelled. So v e square will be equal to 2 g m e by r e. It can also be written as 2 g m e by r e square into r e. One r e get cancelled and we get the same value. So v e will be equal to square root of 2 into g m e by r e square into r e. This g m e by r e square, this is the gravitational acceleration at the surface of Earth. So this implies that v e escape speed is equal to square root of the 2 into g into r e. And if we substitute the value, g is 9.81 meter per second square at the surface of Earth, and radius of the Earth is 6400 kilometer. So approximately it will come 11.2 kilometer per second. This is the escape speed for the Earth surface. So 11.2 kilometer per second is the minimum speed with which if a particle is projected, then it will escape from the Earth gravitational field. Let's take some example.